New developments today in the 20-year-old investigation of the 1988 explosion that killed six Kansas City firefighters. Part of the case might be reopened. KMBC tonight's Michael Mahoney is live with these new developments. Michael?
Laura, we're at the memorial for those six firefighters who died near here back in 1988. We can take a closer look at it right now. Their deaths shocked Kansas City, and in the mid-1990s, it led to the conviction of five people for starting the fire that caused their deaths. Now, after an article in Sunday's Kansas City Star newspaper, U.S. Attorney John Wood is asking the Justice Department to consider looking at that case again. That fire at what is now part of 71 Highway prompted a huge explosion that killed the firefighters. In the daylight the day after, the area looked devastated by the force of the blast. Sunday, the Star report accused federal investigators of intimidating and threatening some witnesses to win long prison sentences against five people accused of starting that fire. Today, U.S. Attorney John Wood announced that even though they remain confident of the case, he is asking Washington to review those assertions of witness intimidation to assure justice is served. Congressman Emanuel Cleaver was mayor of Kansas City at the time.
If we fail to investigate this now, I think that it is one of the most blatant malfunctions of justice that we've ever seen in this city.
But Cleaver adds he thinks the five now in prison knew of the explosion and he doubts their innocence. The lawyer Cheryl Pilot, however, represents defendant Darlene Edwards, and she thinks prosecutors did miss important evidence.
And there are many, many pieces of evidence that have come together to create a picture, frankly, substantially different from what was presented by the government at trial.
The request for the Justice Department to look at the witness intimidation accusations does not mean the five people in jail will get new trials. In fact, a lawyer for defendant Brian Shepard thinks that's unlikely.
It all comes back to that kind of testimony. So I applaud the fact that someone's looking back into this, but I don't know how helpful that's really going to be at the end of the day.
Just because all these witnesses are people that have questionable ability to tell the truth?
Yeah.
Now, the important thing to remember about this is that this is not a call for a new trial. It is a call to have a special prosecutor outside of the U.S. Attorney's Office, but somewhere in the Justice Department, to look at these allegations that witnesses were tampered with, and then they'll take it from there. This is not a new trial for the five people who were convicted of starting the fire that killed the firefighters. Back to you.
Hey, Michael, what would it take if there was going to be a new trial?
Laura, quite a bit. A source very close to this said that it would literally take something as convincing as DNA evidence or perhaps an admission by somebody that they, not the folks that were in jail, started the fire. Getting a new trial for these five folks is going to be a very steep hurdle for the defense and their advocates to climb. Back to you.
All right, Michael, thank you. And legal experts say it's unlikely anyone who may have lied in the case would be charged with perjury because the statute of limitations has passed.